Hey, what's up guys? And before today start, go ahead and check out the two new series that I started over on Anime King, my main channel. And if this is the first time hearing about it, go ahead and check it out where you can enjoy over 600 plus what ifs. So I post a new episode of What If Naruto Was Trained by Kaguya, and also What If Naruto created his own village after getting banned from the Leaf Village. So go ahead and check those out and enjoy. And I also post a new episode of Uchiha Naruto on this channel, so go ahead and check it out. But for right now, I'm going to be giving you part 39 of Naruto, the God of Shinobi. Remember to get this one to 100 likes as usual, share it to all of your friends on your social media platform, and also go over to my community tab on Anime King and vote for the three what if suggestions. The one with the highest vote I am going to be picking and doing that what if on this channel, Anime King 2. So go over there and vote. And thank you guys for all of your help and your support. And without further ado, let's get straight into this. So the last time we left off, Naruto decided to allow Hinata to be on his team because she's so loyal to him and do whatever he say, killing her own father. After that, the war then started as Naruto came to where the Kage meeting was, as he then sent out his troops, as a portion of them, with Mikoto and Sasuke, went to go and take out Danzo, while Naruto sent Fu, Yujito and B to wipe out the samurais. So Naruto and the rest of them went inside of the Kage's meeting, shocking everyone, as all of them were even more shocked when the Raikage and Mei got up as they were on Naruto's side. But Aniki refused to stand by Naruto, and Naruto tell him to watch himself because he don't take treason lightly, as Aniki could do nothing but flee. So yeah, that was basically the last part we left off. You guys can switch across the playlist and check it out for yourself. So let's start this new episode. After Naruto said that he came for what Kabuto has, Tsunade looked at Kabuto. What is that supposed to mean? She asked. But before Kabuto could respond, someone else spoke. I have a question for you, said Gaara as he looked at Naruto. What is it? Naruto asked. I want to know about the information that I gathered. What is it about the Uzumaki clan being destroyed by Kumo, Kiri, and the Stone Village? Mei flinched at the reminder, while Ei just stood there. Naruto raised an eyebrow at the question. What is it to you? I am just trying to understand why you're doing this, said Gaara. Naruto shook his head. You of all people should understand why I'm doing this, Gaara, he said. But Naruto turned his attention on Tsunade and Kabuto instead. Now, shall we begin? Tsunade, said Kakashi next to her. What will we do? Tsunade had her eyes narrowed as she looked at Kabuto. Mito then jumped down between Mei and Ei. There is nothing you can do, she responded, but to give up, just accept that you can't win. Tsunade turned as she looked at her grandmother. I have a bone to pick with you. Mito raised an eyebrow. Really? Fine then. Let's see if you can entertain me for a while then, my granddaughter. Mito was more than confident that Naruto would recover the scroll from Kabuto and do what they wanted, so it will be fun to toy with Tsunade for a while. Mito then appeared at the exit, motioning for Tsunade to follow her as Tsunade took off with her. Now that that is taken care of, shall we start here? Naruto said as he looked at Kabuto. Mifune then appeared in front of Naruto as he swung his sword ready to slice Naruto, but it was blocked by another sword that belonged to Kushina. I always want to test my Kenjutsu against a samurai, Kushina stated with a smirk. I will be your opponent, she stated as she pushed him back. Mifune, said Okotsu, one of Mifune's right-hand man. I will deal with this on my own, stated Mifune as he looked at Kushina. Gaara, said Tankuro, what will we do? Not interrupting, said Mei as she stepped forward along with Ei and Darui and the rest. Gaara narrowed his eyes. We are at a disadvantage here. Oi, said Roshi, as he and Han landed in front of Kakashi and Okotsu. We will be the ones fighting you. Kakashi narrowed his eyes. I have to finish this quick, he thought. Obito smirked to himself as he disappeared in a vortex. Naruto, along with Yagura and Fuka and Utagata, jumped down as they landed in front of a grinning Kabuto. So, it is 4-1, said Kabuto as he shook his head. Those numbers seem unfair. Why don't we even them out? As he brought his hand together and 6 coffins rose from the ground, Naruto smirked. Now how is bringing 6 of your little puppets fair? Oh wait, they don't add up to anything in the end. As Kabuto smirked as well. Perhaps, but these 6 I have made specially for you, he said while chuckling. As Naruto looked, as the coffins fell to the ground in front of it, revealing the 6 individuals that were inside. As Fuka could only stare in shock as she gazed at the 6 individuals that were inside of the coffins. Yagura narrowed his eyes as Utagata only sighed. Damn people, making this complicated, he thought, as the 6 individuals were Hashirama, Tobirama, Hiruzen, Minato, Madara, and Uchiha Aizuna, Madara's brother. Back with Sasuke. Is this Sasuke? Thought Karin as she looked at Sasuke's back. His chakra, it's cold. As Danzo merely looked at Sasuke with an impassive look on his face. Do you seriously think that you can beat me, boy? Sasuke didn't respond as he just stared at Danzo with a killing intent. Sasuke, said Mikoto with a serious tone, I trust that you can handle him. As Sasuke gave a small nod to confirm. Mikoto nodded as she glanced at Sagetsu. Oi, you, let's go. We have to make sure none of Danzo's lucky interfere. Sagetsu grinned as he unstrapped his sword. I take it that killing is allowed. As Mikoto nodded. In fact, kill all of them. Leave no survivors. As Sagetsu grinned. As Sasuke, always try and stop him from killing. As they went after the rude Anvus. How foolish, said Danzo as he unstrapped the bandages that were around his hand as he already take off the construction that was on it. As Danzo already recognized who Mikoto was, while surprised, he would have find out more later when he captured her. He was already thinking of plans for her, mainly using her to recreate the Uchiha clan, one that would be under his control this time. Sasuke's eyes widened as he saw the amount of Sharingans on Danzo's arm. How disgusting, thought Karin. You, said Sasuke in anger. How did you get those? That will take too much time to explain, said Danzo. As he then rushed at Sasuke with a kunai, as Danzo stabbed forward, but his blade broke in half by a purple barrier. This is Susanoo, he said, as he saw the ribcage. As Sasuke glared down at him deadly, as the Susanoo hand grabbed Danzo and squished him. That's it, thought Karin with a smile on her face. Though she then felt Danzo's chakra again. After a long while, this battle went on like cannon, but Sasuke found out that Danzo was using the Izanagi. As then, he looked over at his root agents to see all of them dead. As Sagetsu was drinking a bottle of water and Mikoto started to walk up to him. Don't even think of using Shisui's eye, she said as she placed her hands on her hips, because my Sharingan will nullify Shisui's genjutsu. That's not possible, said Danzo, as he thought that she was bluffing. I have trained myself very hard in genjutsu because you possess Shisui's eye and his genjutsu in the process. My goal was to kill you, and I didn't want to be caught in the genjutsu and used for one of your little schemes. As Danzo looked at his arm, as Sasuke had killed him enough time, as his Izanagi was over, as he glanced at his hand to see that he has one Sharingan eye open, I have to put an end to this. I will have to save Shisui's eye to defeat Mikoto, thought Danzo as he rushed at Sasuke again. Sasuke could only smirk as he rushed at Danzo as he brought out his sword, both lightning and the Amaterasu flames around it. As Danzo pulled out a kunai coated with wind chakra, the both of them vanished and appeared in front of each other. as they pierce each other. Foolish boy, said Danzo, as he waited for his Izanagi to bring him back. As he started to cough up blood, what's going on? Why is Izanagi not working? Itachi, said Sasuke in a low tone. This makes one. Danzo's eyes widened as he saw Sasuke in front of him disappear, as another Sasuke was behind him, piercing him right through his chest with his sword, with his eternal Mangekyo Sharingan activated. How? Thought Danzo, as he fell to his knees. Genjutsu, said Sasuke. You thought that you had one still open, but all of them were closed. You also thought that it was a real me that rushed at you. As Sasuke shake his head. You're through, Danzo, said Mikoto as she appeared beside Sasuke. I will be taking what you stole now. I am not through yet, as markings start to appear all over him. Sasuke, get back, said Mikoto as she recognized what they were. Back with Naruto, Madara. That bastard, Kurama growled out. As Naruto blocked out Kurama, as he focused on the situation at hand, Kabuto smirked. As the revived shinobis opened their eyes, this is it, he said. Madara opened his eyes as he looked around, as he saw Hashirama along with his brother. So it has happened then, he thought. What is this? Said Minato as he looked around as well. I thought that I was dead. It's Orochimaru, said Sarutobi with a sigh. Unfortunately not, as all of them turned around to see Kabuto. Who are you? Minato asked. I am Kabuto. Brother, said Aizuna as he saw Madara. What's going on here? Madara, said Hashirama with surprise. As Madara merely grunted, as Tobirama could only scowl as he looked at the two Uchiyas. I suppose, welcome back to the living world is in order, said Naruto as he took a step forward. When he reached, he narrowed his eyes at Minato. I didn't think that I would be seeing you again, Minato, said Naruto. Minato could only look at the person in front of him with a confused look. Do I even know? As he then stopped, as he saw the whisker marks. Naruto, he said with wide eyes. Naruto, said Sarutobi, as it was almost impossible to recognize him. Is that you? Glad to see you too, old man, said Naruto with a grin. Just what happened here? Said Minato. Time to take over, said Kabuto, as he formed hand signs. As Tobirama looked at Kabuto, this is my jutsu, do you really think you can? As he was cut off. Yes, I can, said Kabuto. As Tobirama, look, he couldn't move his body. As Hashirama raised an eyebrow, this was surprising, he couldn't move either. Brother, mind explaining? Asked Aizuna as he looked at Madara. Madara, for his part, merely stared at Naruto, so it seems like everything is going towards plan, he said with a small smirk. As Naruto shrugged, I don't know, because Obito is the only one that you told everything. Speaking of, where is he? Naruto wondered, as he couldn't help noticing that Obito was gone. Madara smirked when he heard that. It seems I made the right choice in choosing you, Obito. Madara, said Tobirama. Tell us, what the hell is going on? Now! Madara merely glanced at him. You're in no position to demand anything, seeing that he's pulling the string, said Madara as he glanced at Kabuto. We can't handle them, said Fuka. Besides Naruto, they're too strong. Then step back, said Naruto, as he then stepped forward. We will help you, said Yagura as he took a step forward, as well as Utakata. If you want, Naruto said, as he focused on the six in front of him. Just what is going on? Asked Sarutobi, as his body moved into a battle stance as the rest. Hashirama glanced at Madara's pleased look. Something tells me that this is all you're doing, he stated, as Madara simply grunted again. You could say that, as Tobirama scowled. I suppose there's no choice then, said Aizuna, as his Sharingan activated. And you're not going to tell me anything, are you? He asked as he glanced at Madara one more time, as Madara only grunted again, no response. As Minato could only look at his son in sadness, it seems this cannot be helped. Naruto smirked as he activated his Rinnegan, as red chakra started to surround him, Utagata and Yagura, as Fuga merely jumped back, as she couldn't handle herself in this fight. Madara then activated his eternal Mangekyo Sharingan as a blue energy surrounded him. I suppose it's time to see if they have chosen well, Uzumaki Naruto, said Madara, as Sharingan met Rinnegan. Currently on top of the cliff where Naruto and the others were before they came down, Black Zetsu chuckled to himself. It seems like it all worked out just as you believe, Madara, he said. Black Zetsu had sensed the arrival of Madara Chakra a few minutes ago, the only explanation being Kabuto. As Black Zetsu was enjoying himself, as he knew that the show has just started. Now let's see if you have already surpassed Madara, Naruto, he said. Back with Naruto. Oi, are you serious about fighting all of them at the same time? Of course I am. This is exactly what I've been waiting for. As Kurama merely chuckled. Well then, don't think about leaving me out of this. I also want a part in tearing Madara to shreds. Will do, said Naruto, as he cut the conversation with his Biju for the moment to focus on his opponents in front of him. Both Madara and Aizuna then stepped forward as the both of them inhale at the same time. Fire style, fireball jutsu, as they launched two powerful fire towards Naruto. Naruto took a step forward as he absorbed the giant fireball as they fused together. As he flipped back as he was forced to dodge, wood spikes erupted from the ground. Nice reflexes, commented Hashirama with a smile on his face as he held up his hand. Tobirama then rushed at Naruto, but he quickly ducked down to dodge a kick from Yagura. I always wanted the chance to fight you, Second Hokage, stated Yagura, the only man able to generate water from the air itself, Senju Tobirama. It's an honor. Tobirama rushed at him as the both of them started to engage in taijutsu. Naruto landed as he grabbed both incoming kicks from Madara and Aizuna as he spinned them around and threw them, but he then disappeared in a dark flash as Minato appeared behind him in a yellow flash. As he noticed Minato three-pronged kunai, as he looked down at Kabuto, so you equipped them with weapon as well, as Kabuto smirked, but of course, I came prepared. Naruto could comment as an entire tree appeared behind him, Hashirama standing on the tree. Two tendrils then shot from the ground and came towards him. Fire style, fireball jutsu. Both Madara and his brother appear from beside him, firing two fireballs. As the wood tentacles come in from a front, and Minato was behind him. I am sorry, Naruto, said Minato, but this is it. As all attacks collided with Naruto, but Minato was stopped in his tracks. When all of the smoke cleared, Naruto was surrounded by Susanoo, on complete form, as it was black with red lines running all over it, and it had a face like a fox. Its eyes were red, making it look more demonic, and it held a sword in his hand. As Naruto turned and focused his eternal Mangekyo Sharingan on Madara's. So, this is your eternal Mangekyo Sharingan, Madara said in a whisper. But Aizumo, who was beside him, heard it. The eternal Mangekyo Sharingan? Thought Aizumo, as he then turned to Naruto. But how is this possible? As Kabuto was mentally drooling, experimenting on him. Will be fun, he thought. Madara then transformed into his own Susanoo. Will we see which one is better? Naruto smirked as he turned and faced Madara. I thought that you would never ask. Oi, don't forget about us, said Hashirama, as he went through hand sign at a fast pace. But he was then trapped in a bubble. As Hashirama raised an eyebrow, as he noticed Utagata a distance away. So, it's you. As Madara and Naruto Susanoo blade clashed together. As Madara's other hand of the Susanoo gained another blade and swing at Naruto's unprepared side. Kurama, it's your turn, said Naruto, as two yellow hands emerged from the Susanoo and grabbed onto Madara's blade. As both Madara and Naruto smiled at each other, I am still here, said Aizuna, as his Sharingan changed into the Mangekyo, and his Susanoo flared up around him, as it was dark red, as it reminded Naruto of Itachi's. "Now, how will you handle this?" thought Madara, as him and Aizuna went to attack Naruto. Naruto's Susanoo then changed into his level 2 form, as it gained more armor and now 2 blades. As the second blade blocked Aizuna, Susanoo's attack, Naruto then rushed to hand signs as he created a torrent of wind and fire as they hit Madara Susanoo as it cracked the armor. "Not bad," thought Madara, as he then noticed that the attack was still going. "What?" That was his last thought, as the attack broke through Susanoo, hitting him. "Madara," said Aizuna as he saw the way his brother Susanoo broke. "Now to deal with you," thought Naruto as he turned his attention to Aizuna. Aizuna was brought down to his knees as his Susanoo started to get attacked by Naruto's 2 blades and the giant fox hand. "My Susanoo won't hold," he thought. "Oi, Kurama," said Naruto. Sensing what his host wanted, Kurama grinned. "Let's do it," he said. Aizuna's eyes got wide as Kurama in his Bijuu form emerged from Naruto, as it was already performing its strongest attack, the Bijuu bomb. As the fox released the attack, as Aizuna, Susanoo was blown apart as it was teared to threads, as he was also blown apart as well. Both Sarutobi and Kabuto jumped on top of the now destroyed ceiling as snow was falling down on them. "This was not how it's supposed to go," thought Kabuto as he sweat a bit despite the cold weather. Naruto calmly walked up to Aizuna, whose body was already reanimating. "This is the end for you," Naruto said, as he activated his Rinnegan. "I am already dead, but it's too bad that I won't see what is going to happen to you. But good luck, Uzumaki Naruto." Naruto merely took hold of his head as he ripped his soul out and released it. Naruto then turned his attention to a kneeling Madara as his body started to regenerate, and Minato stood beside him. Naruto could only look at Minato with a smirk on his face, as Minato was shocked. "You?" "Yes, father. I am this powerful. More powerful than you ever were, and also faster. That's how I defeated you last time, wasn't it?" As Madara, who was being reformed, "So, you're Namikaze Minato. I suppose I should be thanking you. You are a big part of this." Minato frowned as he looked at him. "What are you talking about?" "Sealing the Kyuubi inside of me," said Naruto, as he looked at Madara. "Kurama?" repeated Minato with a raised eyebrow, as he got a curious look from Madara. Naruto shook his head. "Don't worry about that. But you should know, Madara, I am not your pawn. I choose to be here." Madara smiled as he stood up, as his body completely regenerated. "I never said that you were my pawn, did I? I also never said that you didn't choose to go down this path. But what I am saying, for your father to see the Kyuubi inside of you, that is why everything became possible. All of these things." "What?" said Minato with wide eyes. "You're saying that I'm the cause for turning my son into this person?" Madara only gave him a glance. "A major cause," he said. A thud interrupted their conversation as they looked to see a heavily injured Utagata trying to get up with Hashirama standing over him, as Madara smirked. "It's about time that you defeated him, Hashirama." "So Utagata could handle him," thought Naruto. That caused Kurama to snort. "Were you expecting him to win?" "No, not really," said Naruto. Hashirama then calmly walked over as he stood beside Minato and Madara, as the three of them stand side by side. "Now to continue," thought Naruto as he got ready. On the other side of the room, Yagura was panting heavily as Tobirama stood a few feet away from him. "So Utagata lost," thought Yagura as he looked at Utagata. "It was to be expected. He was up against Senju Hashirama," said the Bijuu inside of him. "Yeah, you're right," thought Yagura, as he then turned his attention to Tobirama. From the rooftop, Kabuto smirked as he gained confidence again. As Sarutobi could only look down at the fight, as he was troubled. "Naruto," he muttered. "Let's see what you can do, Uzumaki Naruto," said Hoshirama with a smile. Naruto could only sigh. One of the strongest shinobi of the world, smiling like that all the time. As Kurama chuckled, well, let's do this. But guys, gonna be end this episode right here. Before I see the next part of this, you already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. Remember to share to all of your friends on your social media platform. But for now, I'm out of here. Peace.